Welcome to Beaver Off-Road on YouTube. What I'm going to be doing today is installing the Beaver Off-Road Skid Plate. This is mine. This is my test model, my prototype. I've been running. I took it off to do some other work. I've got everything set up. I've got my mounting plates, my U-bolts, everything set in place. I'm going to give a quick rundown and show you just how easy it is to install this. It's pretty simple. This is a two-piece plate. It's bolted together in the middle. It's got tapered screws that are flush mounted on the back side, so the hole underneath will be smooth. It does have an overlap with a small edge there. This is quarter inch aluminum, 5098, strongest aluminum there is. It's the same aluminum that they use for aluminum bolt hauls. So what we're going to do is we're going to slide this under there and show you just how quick it is to start in the back also, whichever is easier. I just start in the front. Let's get that on. Alright, all we need is to get the one corner on right now. And we can set up our floor jack. There's five mounting points on each side. flat, huh? We won't do it by feel. I haven't done enough times. Now I'm going to go so tight because it is a lock nut on here, so I can only get that to lock. We can slide it underneath the whole thing here. And get this size mounted up. Through the U-bolt through the bracket correctly. Try to hold too many out. Too many nuts at one time. Okay, that one's on there. Grab it back onto the other side. Now once it's mounted, you want to kind of leave the frame's a little thinner in the rear here and in the front. So avoid dropping down too far. But it's best if you leave the floor jack underneath the back part until you get it tightened up. And you can let it hang down, but if you keep it up there. And the other thing is, the way these U-bolts work on here, you don't, once you get it around the frame and you don't have anything that's being caught by the U-bolts or bound up behind you or whatever, as you tighten them up, it's a self-centering system, so you don't really have to worry about laying. I mean, you have to get aligned a little bit so you can get it mounted. Okay, we got the front. Here we're clearing our rule of thumb. It's a little better when the machine's clean. You don't get quite as dirty as the button on getting here. But who cleans the machine? That's no fun. This set of bolts here is probably the hardest one to access, and it's not even too bad. It's just you have your frame support that you're kind of working around. And two people, I mean, obviously, if you have two people helping you, if you're going to do it a heck of a lot quicker. But one person is easily done, and the protection you get from this is just unbelievable, because you can just fly over anything, and it's protecting everything that's in between your frame rails, lets you slide over logs, rocks, everything. Every obstacle will give you a little bit better, and kind of have to help you with high centering a little bit, because your frame won't dig in, and the whole thing will slide over a little bit better. Not saying it'll stop you from high centering, but it can actually help you get over a high center situation. because I thought it would be a little bit better if I had the machine a little cleaner. It doesn't help that I'm knocking dirt off in my face. But we ought to get this on here and go do some riding. And like I said, I did some work on the cooling system. So I did need to get in there and access the points underneath. Around the frame, so it's not going to crush the frame or do any damage to it. You're not drilling into the frame or doing anything like that. The system goes in there, and you can see you basically just have that little bit of edge of, and these have a 48,000 pound tensile strength, so you're not going to be breaking these U-bolts by catching a rock, not like if you were to bolt the system on, where you can catch the head of the bolt, that could just shear that right off. So that's really all it takes. I'm just going to go through and tighten it all up. That'll take another, probably 5-10 minutes to get it tightened up. It'll center itself, and that's what it takes to put on the BOR off-road skid plate.
Thank you for
watching. Well, you can see I got the skid plate all bolted on tight. I want to give a little demonstration also. It's kind of surprising how when this is bolted up tight against frame, using my attachment system, how much more rigid the machine comes. Going on like back roads and washboard roads, you get a ton of cowl shape, windshield shape. The skid plate, when that's bolted on, just tightens up the whole unit. I don't get near as much much shape and cowl shape in it, and it just makes the whole machine a lot more solid. The other good feature is that now when the skid plate's on, if you have good floor jack, you can see I can jack this thing up in any location, really. I can jack it up in the front. I got it right in the middle. You can see both sides are up. And you can jack it up. Check the wheel bearings. Check it out. Gives you the opportunity to center of gravity. does a lot to keep the center of gravity in the ride better. So that added weight is actually kind of a benefit of riding a ride. You can see I can just jack this thing right up as long as I get my jack tight. And right now I'm just about jacking up the entire weight of the machine. You can see I'm just about in center. I could actually bounce this machine and have it on one tire on the ground. So the skid plate is obviously strong and is doing a job. I can makes it very solid. So that's a kind of demonstration of BOR skid plate, the benefits of it, how it stiffens up the frame. You're not going to hurt anything underneath, and you're certainly not going to hurt the skid plate. And but that's just a good idea of how it goes on. Pretty simple to bolt on, and what it does for the machine and the benefits to get along with it. And I'll give you a quick view. We can take the camera here. Let me get this set up. And you can see this is what it looks like underneath. You can see the attachment system, how that goes. You're pretty much flat underneath there. And that's how the whole system works. Thank you.